Good day, guys. Hi. Today I'm gonna teach you some tricks and for against the four-wheel disengage in Nissan Navara D40. This is a common factor for Nissan Navara D40, or else the or otherwise it's normal with the other 4x4 vehicles as well, because this is the same thing I have experienced in Nissan Patrol as well. To the point that I'm going to talk about Nissan Navara D40. So basically, see, once you engage with the four wheel, either from a high or the low, most of the time, so when you turn it to a low, four wheel low, so this is the indicator that you are getting. So when you turn back to H, the high, so it basically engage all four wheels together, but when you put it back to the two wheel, just press it, right? So it does not disengage. So what we have to do is, because in order to disengage, either you have to take the vehicle into a gravel, or just, you know, park in a straight road and reverse it for about 200 meters on a same speed, that will disengage the four wheel. If not, what happens is, it related to either of the relays. So there are four relays on with regards to the four wheel engage and disengage, which I will show you guys. If all the relays are response, or if the relays works good, so the second thing that you have to check is the neutral switch. So there are three switches, or those switches are works as a sensors kinda. So though you have to look after all these all those three sensors, once for the neutral, for the one for the transfer. So other, so you have to check them. You have to take them off. I'll show you guys how to do that. Take them off and check the continuity. If those are works perfectly, so then there is nothing to do with that. The lastly, what you have to check is the actuator. So actuator is a component which works electronically to control the manual four wheel selector. So that is basically sits at the back of the gearbox. So what you have to do is, you have to, you know, take off the power socket and insert it back, or basically if it is a corrode or basic oxides, so that's one of the reason it does not engage or disengage. There are fact actually, so in case if that doesn't, so we have to take off the whole actuator and then select the you have to deselect the four wheel to the two wheel. You know, it make the whole lot of mechanical and electronical or mechatronic workflow. So but I'm gonna teach you guys the very quick tips to disengage the four wheel in case it does not. So this, or otherwise, unless otherwise, if this tricks does not respond to disengage the four wheel, what you have to do is, you basically have to follow the whole those workflow steps that I have told you earlier, from the actuator, sorry, from the four wheel relays to the neutral switches to the actuator. So what I'm going to teach you guys is, so right now it does not you know, switch off or disengage. In this case, you have to do is, keep the four wheel switch selector as in two wheel, and switch off the engine, right? And you have to take the lever to the neutral position. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna on the switch to the ACC, depress the brake and put it to neutral. Make sure you have to pull the handbrake, right? And then start the vehicle, right? So it does not respond.
So repeat the same thing.
So
keep the gear position into the neutral
and switch off the engine. In order to switch off the engine, you have to
put the lever into the park mode
and switch off the engine. Right
now, you need to take the gear lever back to the neutral. What I'm going to do is I'm not going to use the key at this moment, so I'm going to take it by depressing the brake pedal, and then the shift locker. I'm going to manually press the shift locker and pull the gear up,
put it on a neutral mode, and then I'm gonna switch on the key. And let me just reverse the vehicle for a bit. Put it on park mode. Put it back to the neutral mode. Switch off the engine. Switch it back on. Low, and drag it forward. There it is. It got off. So this is what you need to do is, so keep the gear on a neutral position. If it is an auto, keep it on a neutral position. And then start the engine, and once it is start, so you have to either reverse it or take the vehicle into the forward. So put it on a T and then drive just about 1 foot ahead. So this will disengage. So this means it's proof that there's nothing to do with the four-wheel actuator. So nothing to do with the four actuator or the four-wheel switches or the relays, the four-wheel relays. So this is basically, if you are not using the four-wheel very often, this is something very normal. But if you are a regular four-wheel user, this is this would not occur. But in my cases, I rarely use the four-wheel, so this was the reason it is probably not being disengaged. So but these are the fact that you have to do is, you don't need to remove everything from the under the bonnet hood to the down need the four-wheel. So this is a basic trick that you have to follow it, and then it will definitely disengage, unless otherwise there is no issue with the all those three components in system. All right, so I hope this is very informative, and then this can be make use for you to disengage four-wheel in case if does not help you, or if you got stuck in anywhere on the road or the off-road. So this is same tips you can follow it in a manual gear. So that was the same thing you have to do with. Right now I don't have it, but I have tested it. Once I get the manual gear, it's another D40, I can demonstrate the same thing with the same simulations that I have done it. Once again, put the position back to the two-wheel mode, and switch the gear shift to the neutral on auto. We can put it on the new neutral, which is N, or if it is a manual, keep it on a keep it on a neutral position and switch off the engine and switch back the engine. Yeah, start the engine and take the vehicle either to forward or the reverse, then this will be disengaged. So in manual there's a bit different, because once it is on a neutral mode, it basically get disengage the position. But with regards to the automatic, once you put the gear into the park mode, so this park mode get completely break the whole four wheel system along with the gear shiftings. You can see there's a video which I have done in the past. I will, you know, post a link in that, so where you will get the ATP mod activated. So when the ATP mod activated means that when the gear shift is, you know, positioned to the park mode, all the parking basically the neutralizing the gear system will get engaged with the parking mode. There was a main reason it does not get disengaged when it's, you know, switched to the four wheel or the low. So this is a trick that you have to follow. We put it on a neutral mode and then switch on the engine, then it will be disengaged. Then you don't see this flashing the flashing indicator on a four wheel mode, right? Thank you very much, guys. If you have any question, you can, you know, post the comments. I'm more than happy to reply all. Thank you very much for being with us. So this is the fuse box that controls the four wheel. So these are the three relays that I was talking about. So you have to, you know, remove them and then check the continuity and then functionality of these three relays. So if there is a connectivity, good connectivity on these three relays, just forget about this and then leave this, and then you have to move to the next level, which is underneath of the gearbox. Let's go there and have a look. So I'm just trying to demonstrate this for you guys to disengage the four wheel, unless my tip does not work for you all. So these are the two switches sits on the transfer case, and this is the neutral switch, and this is the actuator I was talking about.
So these are the three switches, or the sensor switches, which is sits on the transfer box. So in case if the four wheel disengage or the does not engage, so either way of you have to check them as well. So these are the two part numbers, two switch assist, which you know, are fixed together. And this is the switch, natural neutral switch, which is fixed along a side of the transfer box. So there's a difference between that in the pins. So if you look at this, which is the which is this part number, so it has the green circle in it. And if you look at the pin size, so this pins and the socket size, this both are same. So is there an identical, but you have to mark them before you take them off from the transfer box, right? And if you look at the neutral switch, so it has the very close pin type, and it's a deep between deep. So I will show you on the wire harness. Let me know. I don't think I have a wire harness in that. So this is something that you have to check while you're fixing it. Right now I cannot go under to take them off, but I'm sure you can get an idea of what I have showed in the video in that, right? So check the connectivity. I will show you how you guys can check the connectivity by using the multimeter.
So this is how you need to check the connectivity of these switches. So you have to have a multimeter to select it, and then press the switch button. And then if you notice the connectivity, so this seems to be working fine. If you don't get it, yes, you have to change them.